Hello everyone, and welcome to my very first ever fragrance haul video. This idea was championed by Robes08, and saw it on his channel and figured, you know what, this might be a good idea as something to add to my channel, so I kind of threw it in. I don't really ever highlight fragrances that I buy. I just buy them, throw it on. I might mention it a little bit on my fragrance fireside chats, but overall I don't. But this time I decided to kind of throw it on because I got so many fragrances at the same time, whether it be through a contest, whether it be that I bought them, but I got them all at the same time, and I figured, you know what, let me just throw it into a video, add a little bit of spice, add a little bit of variety on my channel, and see how it does. So it could become a mainstay. Let me know how you feel either way in the comments below, okay? So about 2 weeks ago, I went to a grand opening, basically, of a niche perfumery store that's contained within Brooklyn near the Atlantic City Terminal, called Twisted Lily is the store's name. So they had a event, basically, that would, they basically were charging 20% off on all of their fragrances that they offer there. And they also had a contest, which was basically a raffle. It was a raffle for $1,200 worth of fragrances. If you bought a fragrance, you were entered into the raffle. So, or buying anything from the store basically would enter you in the raffle. So I bought a couple things and was entered into the raffle, and I won. So I won over $1,200 worth of fragrances, adding on to what I actually bought as well, and it's a pretty big fragrance haul. So I'm going to be highlighting those fragrances. I'm going to be sniffing them for you, showing to whatever, basically, and I'll give you my first impressions of a couple of them, even though I've smelled some of them already. All right? So, or most of them already, actually. So without any further ado, let's introduce the first fragrance. We have, from the house of Ramon Monegal, Curel. Now, this one I specifically went out and bought specifically because I wanted a leather-based fragrance or some more leather-based fragrances. I don't really have that many, and I figured I'd add it to my arsenal. This one is supposedly an interpretation of leather-based fragrances, but it comes off pretty leathery to me as well. Now, when you screw it off, be careful with these fragrances if you ever buy one. Why? Well, it always catches me by surprise, but this is the actual fragrance in here. Most people will logically grab the top and pull it off. Here's the thing. This cap, as you can see, is, I pulled it out carefully. Why? Because this cap, it goes like that, basically. It comes, it has a natural flip off. So if you pull it out real fast, it might go like that, and then you'll basically feel that it's shocking. So natural reaction, pull it out, and you'll freak out, basically, like I have a couple times. But either way. Here's the fragrance, it comes off, very nice presentation, very heavy, very durable, you can't really, you know, knock it on that quality on there. The actual scent itself, got a couple of scent strips inside. It's, actually I know what it smells like, so I'm not going to spray it, but it's basically a leather base. It feels kind of, and it has a very smooth leather, feels kind of like Dior Homme Intense, the lipsticky vibe of the iris. Of iris kind of reminds me, like it's in there. I don't think any iris is in there, but it kind of reminds me of it. Very pleasant, very smooth, very sensual fragrance that, you know, a couple of women at Twisted Lily actually smelled it on me and just absolutely loved it. So I thought it was absolutely great. Got it. So Cura. Let's get this one back in here. The next fragrance, again from the house of Ramon Monegal, Dry Wood. Dry Wood. It's a very small 15 milliliter bottle, but comes off. This is essentially dry woods, as it's as the name suggests. Now, it's got some citrus at the top. It's very, very dry, as the name suggests. It's almost as if it went out of its way. Kind of has like a almost a little bit of a balmy type of a vibe to it, but. Yeah, the citrus never really takes, even the citrus feels dry in the fragrance. It overall, it feels like a definitely dry, citrusy fragrance. But the woods definitely take a prominent, you know, to the foreground, if you will. A prominent presentation or prominent note. So that's Dry Woods. Or Dry Wood. Next one is Lady Day Parfum. Not sure which house this is. I haven't actually looked this one up, but I got a small sample of it. Yeah, Lady Day. And, smells interesting. Kind of has this, I want to say, it's like peachy-ish vibe to it. I'm not sure if it'll be a little bit too feminine, but I'm not going to put it on my skin right now. We'll see how it goes. Interesting. Peachy type of fragrance. All right, next one is from the house of Mona D'Oreo. We've got Eau Absolue. And this one is an interesting one. It has kind of a incense-y type of a vibe to it. Incense type of an old school cologne type of a vibe to it. That's the best way I can describe it without going into it a little bit more. Very strong incense. Like the incense that you burn, basically. One of those type of vibes to it. Interesting. Okay. Next one that I got from DS and Durja. This is a niche house. We've got Siberian Snow. Yeah, Siberian Snow. I haven't actually opened this one up or smelled this one yet. So, all right, let's pray. Do not cut myself. And success. All right. Let's pop this open. So here's the bottle. DS&D. And says Siberian Snow on the bottom. So, I haven't smelled this one before, so I haven't actually had, the reason I haven't smelled most of them is I haven't actually had time. I've been really that busy in the past like week and a half. So, we'll see. All right, Siberian Snow. Huh, interesting. Huh. I'm going to say kind of a minty type of a smell. A little bit of florals in there. A little bit of minty, wood, florals, amber. It almost has this oudy type of a smell to it. I think it has a lot of potential. Maybe they're calling it Siberian Snow because of the mint kind of gives it this... I want to say like icy type of vibe to it. So yes, has a lot of potential. I think I might like it actually. So yes, Siberian Snow by DS and Durja. Next one. Next one is a candle. A Belle Flor called Grapefruit Mugget. Grapefruit Mugut or... I'm butchering this. I'll find out how to say it later. Grapefruit something. I'm probably butchering that one, just destroying it. But either way, it's a candle, comes with, you know, a small set of matches, and... Oh, wow. Yeah, it's got a pretty big grapefruit type of a smell to it. But, yeah. Okay, cool. Oh, wow, that's really waxy. Yeah, I slightly touched it and I've got wax all over my finger now. Or grapefruit wax. Yeah. Wipe it on my... I'm gonna wash those jeans anyway. Alright. Next. Sorry, my nose is starting to itch whenever. Alright, either way. Another one from House of DS and Durja. And this one is... Bowmakers. From DS and Durja. Alright. Let's see what Bowmakers smells like. Says Bowmakers on the bottom. Bowmakers is... All right, let's get out a couple of these. Oh, I like this one. This smells like it has a bit of oud in it. For a reference, for those of you who... It smells a little bit like Tom Ford's Oud Wood. Yeah, it smells like a little bit like Tom Ford's Oud Wood. I like this one. This one I definitely like. What does this have in it? Is there any ingredients? Okay, so apparently, the description for this one, the shops were filled with among the transcendental woods of the 1800s, craftsmen from the Massachusetts Bay Colony built violins and bows in the tiny towns of the Pioneer Valley. The shops were riddled with old mahogany, burled maple shavings, and amber pine rosin, aged walnut, and their secret varnishes. So apparently those are the notes in this. Rosin. Okay, I can see that instead. Yeah, you know what? Actually, this does smell like rosin. I used to play violin when I was younger, and interesting. The smell does. This smell is really interesting. Maybe that's why I like it so much. All right. Bowmakers. Yes, I like this one, for sure. Very nice. Okay. Next one is from Rouge Bunny Rouge. We have Chateaubriand. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Rouge Bunny Rouge Chateaubriand. So this comes off. Jeez. Packaging is right here. All right. Yep. It's here. Comes in this nice frosted bottle. I'm not sure what these images are on the side of it. Maybe a flower, but yeah, very heavy, very nice. Bunny Rouge. Let's see what this one smells like. Peach. Very fruity. Same time, it kind of has something that's kind of taking it down a bit. Interesting. Okay. I'm not sure, I'm not giving it bad or good either way. I'm not sure yet. I'll give it a little bit more time. We'll see how it goes. Chateaubriand. Okay, next fragrance. Got from the house of Memoir Liquide. We've got Le Livre. Le Livre Amour. Believe Amour. This one I have not a chance to smell, but actually I haven't sprayed it on anything. This one came with not only the fragrance, but a little lotion that you can kind of put on as well with it too. Yeah. Ooh, wow. This one is just like heavy vanilla and heavy cream, basically. Like vanilla benzoin. That's all I get from this one. And it's not like some people may maybe thinking Spiritus du Blouvigny, but I don't think so. It's a little bit more blatant and upfront. This really smells like food. Wow. Okay. Interesting. Cotton candy a little bit. Yeah. Interesting. All right. We'll see how this one goes. Next one is, God, all these niche houses have such difficult names, or just names I can't pronounce, so I say they're difficult. Jardins Écrivains Wild. All right. Let's see. All right, we'll see how this one goes. Some time. Interesting. I think a lot of people might like this one. Got kind of a grapefruity type vibe, but it's not fruity at all. It's very, very masculine. has these wood notes that appear to be taking it down a bit. Okay, another one I'm going to have to give a little bit of time. I'm not sure if I, either way, if I like it or dislike it. Interesting. Okay. Let's see. Alright, next one. Archive 69 by Etat Libre. Sorry. Archive 69. So, let's see how this one goes. Here's the bottle. Interesting bottle presentation. Archive 69. I already sprayed it on something on that. Alright, there we go. This one I like. Yeah. This one I definitely like. Very clean. Very professional. This is definitely something I can wear to work almost every day. It's got a little bit of a citrusy type of vibe, but it's not too, you know, funny or too playful. A little bit understated. Might have some projection problems, but we'll see how it does in my skin. Interesting. Archive 69. Okay, I like this one. All right. Down. Next one. Another one from the House of Diaz and Thurja. This is called Mississippi Medicine. Now, I've already smelled this one. Popped this one. Let's see. And now, the description of this one is based on the rituals of the proto-Mississippian death cult of the 1200s. Birch tar, viola, white spruce grounded in incense and cypress root. This one smells like a grave to me, or what I would expect a grave to smell like. And I'm not sure if I would want to walk around smelling like that. Figures I got on my finger, too. Very balmy. This smells like death to me. Like, it reminds me of death. It's not, like, you know, the disgusting decaying body smell or anything like that. But birch, definitely, tar. And there's something in it that really just does remind me of, like, you're walking in, you know, a haunted wooded area. But, you know, actually, now that I'm smelling it, I smelled it a while ago, and I actually didn't like it. But this one, actually, I'm actually liking a little bit better now on second smell. Okay, we'll see how this one does. Mississippi Medicine is this one. All right. Next one. We got Undergreen from the House, or from the House of Undergreen, Gold. Be careful with this one, another one of those surprises that they like to throw you with. Just comes off, and the fragrance is here. Fragrance just pops off. So, comes in this little bottle here, Gold. Alright. I smelled this one before, too, at the fragrance trade show that they have here in New York. And this one, interesting, a bit of a citrusy type of a vibe. It has a metallic type of vibe too. I'm not going to say that it smells like gold, but if their goal is to remind you of metals, then they definitely accomplished it. Yeah, we'll see. I'll definitely need to do some testing on this one just to see how it kind of fares on my skin, but yeah. I feel this one can go either way as well. This actually reminds me of thrift shops for some reason. I don't know why. It just popped into my head. Thrift shops. There's something in there that smells or reminds me like a thrift shop. Like, you know, those dollar stores, that type of thing. All right. And I believe this is the last one. Pretty big fragrance. It's called Modern Man. And they gave me a huge bottle of it. 500 milliliters worth, I think. Modern Man, or sorry, O Modern by Third Man. Huge bottle, basically. It's got this thing. This thing pops off, or comes off if you want it to, but the whole thing is glass. It's got a wood cap, wooden cap. This is a very... I've worn this actually a couple times already, just to kind of see how it is. It's a very understated fragrance. This is a fragrance that's actually good. It's one of those fragrances that are good for people who don't like fragrances or cologne. It's very light. It has a little bit of a... Think of this like ultra light Dior Homme with a citrusy type of a vibe. It's ultra light. Don't think of it. In fact, you know, I'm not saying that it smells like Dior Homme, but it does remind me of it in a little bit, at least in the dry down. So this comes like that. It also comes with, you know, a sprayer. You can go ahead and stick it in there. But yeah, it's huge, 500 milliliters. Okay. Yep. And that's it for fragrances. So that pretty much was my haul. A bunch of fragrances that I got for it. If you have any questions whatsoever on them, please feel free to let me know. More importantly, let me know how the video was. What are your thoughts on it? Anything I can improve on it? I'm pretty sure it just felt kind of weird, awkward doing it, but we'll see how it comes out. All right? Thanks for tuning in, guys. Take care of yourselves. I've got more videos coming out throughout the week, and we'll see how they go. Have a great day. Take care.